ऑल, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। एंड टुडे व्हाट आर वी गोइंग टू डू इज टू रिवाइज ऑल ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ लुब्रिकेंट। मेनी वीडियोस हैव बीन पोस्टेड इन माय प्लेलिस्ट ऑफ लुब्रिकेंट वेयर आई हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज इन डिटेल। नाउ दिस वीडियो इज मेंट टू रिवाइज देम ऑल इन अ वन गो। सो लेट अस क्विकली सी बाय लुब्रिकेंट व्हाट डू वी मीन इज एनी केमिकल सब्सटेंस व्हिच रिड्यूसेस फ्रिक्शन बिटवीन टू स्लाइडिंग सर्फेसेस। सो द फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी वुड लाई basically of a semi-solid lubricant, that is grease. And the grease have two properties. The first one is drop point. As you have seen in the video, a drop point was basically the temperature at which the grease converts into liquid state. So obviously, if sample 1 is getting liquefied at 40 degree and sample 2 is getting liquefied at 90 degree, what does that mean? That means you cannot use it after that. So if you have a machine which is working at 50 degree, so obviously you have to use sample 2 in it, because sample 1 obviously will not be stable because the liquid comes out of the grease at 40 degree. So the major significance is it determines the upper limit of the temperature up to which the grease can function. So this grease can function up to 40 degree and this grease can function up to 90 degree. Second property was penetration index, and it's nothing but the depth in tenth of millimeter that a standard cone penetrates the sample of grease under the conditions of weight, time and temperature. So provided we maintain the constant weight, let's say 50 gram or 100 gram or so, and we take reading for 5 seconds and at room temperature, whatever is the depth, that is what the importance is, and it measures the consistency of grease. So if the sample is showing almost a same readings, almost same means around 1 mm variation, that means that sample is good, is consistent. And if the readings are varying like this, like they are varying haphazardly, then that means the sample is not good. Consistency means that the dispersion of soap and oil is proper. The soap and oil are properly mixed, there are no lumps, there are no oil portion in it. Coming to the properties of lubricating oil. So up till now, what we have seen is the property of semi-solid lubricant. Now we'll go with the liquid lubricant. The first property is oiliness. It's basically the stickiness, the ability with which it is stick to the surface. And obviously it should be high. It should stick to the surface in order to provide a good lubrication. Coming to the second one, which is cloud and pour point. Now, cloud point basically is the temperature at which the lubricant shows cloudiness or haziness. So, the first time when a cloudiness is appeared in the lubricant, that temperature you have to note as a cloud point. And the temperature when the lubricant ceases to flow, it stops pouring, that temperature would be pour point. So obviously pour point would be lesser than the cloud point. You can imagine a coconut oil in the flask. If you decrease the temperature of the flask, what happens? It is starting a wax particle or a precipitate occurs, or a cloudiness or a haziness occurs. That temperature you have to note first, which is cloud point. And the second, when it all settles down and when you tilt it, it's not still flowing. Right? It's not flowing. It's almost set. It's not like that. Correct? So that temperature would be pour point, when it's almost ceases to flow. And what do you get out of it? You get the suitability of the lubricant for lower temperature. So if the machine is working at lower temperature, let's say 5 degree the machine is working, and your sample cloud point is 3 degree and your sample pour point is 10 degree. So are you able to use this sample? No. Why? Because if the pour point is reached, that means this is pour point and this is cloud point, right? So the cloud point is reached means at 10 degree it will start crystallizing, and at 3 degree it will start freezing. So 5 lies in between. So you should not use it. You should use when the value is less than the machine working range. Let's say the cloud point is 4 degree, if it is like that, and then pour point is always lesser than that, so then you can use. So machine is working at 15 degree, cloud point is 10 degree and pour point is 5 degree, so you can safely use it, because the liquid is not going to solidify. It's going to solidify at 10 degree, however the machine is working at 15, so you can safely use. So basically its value should be less than the working range of machine. Coming to the viscosity part, I guess you know that it is the property by which it flows. Ease of flowing is basically viscosity, and the viscosity should not be much low, because in that case the liquid will not remain in the position in the machine, and also it should not be high, because that will create excessive friction. Coming to viscosity index, as you know, it's an empirical number. It's basically a rating which is given to the oil in order to see the effect of temperature on viscosity. So if the oil is a very high quality oil, with respect to quality, if you say the oil is very high quality, now when it is high quality, that means the variation with temperature, the viscosity changes very slightly. If it is a low quality oil, that means the variation of viscosity would be high. So based on that, you give them the rating from 0 to 100. So if you give the mark 0 near 0, that means it's a low quality oil. And low quality oil means that the variation would be high. So if temperature increases, the viscosity of your oil will decrease rapidly. And so is high viscosity index oil. And obviously for a good lubricant, the viscosity index number should be high, because the quality should be high. The steam emulsion number is basically known as demulsification number, and it's nothing but number of seconds an emulsion take to demulsify. And let's say one emulsion take 40 seconds to demulsify, and the another sample, if it makes emulsion, it takes 400 seconds to demulsify. So obviously this sample is better, because for that sample the machine will remain idle for 40 seconds because the lubricant is busy in demulsifying. But after that, it will regain its position. It will start lubricating. Correct? But here what happens is, lubricant will take 400 seconds to get back to its original state. And for that duration, the machine may suffer. The working may suffer. So obviously, for a good lubricant, it should be less. It should easily demulsify. The emulsion should not be stable. Coming to the flash and fire point, as the name suggests, first time when you observe a flash, when a source of flame is brought near it. So when a source of flame is brought near your oil and the oil is heating, you are increasing the temperature, vapor comes out of it, and it gives you spark of light, flash of light. That temperature would be flash point. Now once the flash point is reached, obviously it will start giving the flash. Now once the flash is stable up to 5 seconds, you can call it as a fire. And that would be the fire point. So basically, if you have a flash point, let's say 50 degree, and if you have a fire point, which is like 60 degree. Now, if you have machine 1, which is working at 40 degree, and machine 2, which is working at 55 degree, and machine 3, which is working at 70 degree. So in which machine can you use this safely, right? Think about it. In 40 degree, or 55 or 70. If you use it in 70 and the fire point is 60, then the machine may get fire, catch fire when the source of flame would be there. Correct? So you cannot use it here. When the machine is 55 degree, working at 55. Now flash point is reached 50 degree. Fire point is not reached. But when the flash point is reached, the spark may be there and the spark may catch fire. So we cannot want to take that risk. So obviously no. So machine 40 degree means the good lubricating oil should have flash and fire point at least above the temperature at which it is to be used. It should be higher than the working range of machine. So both of the things are very important parameters for the machines who are working at higher temperature operation, and they have a risk of a source of flame. Coming to the next one, which is aniline point, it's the temperature at which the equal volume of aniline and oil are miscible. They get mixed. So let's say if the sample 1 is giving you 70 degree aniline point and sample 2 is giving you 100 degree aniline point, what does that mean? That means sample 2 is not easily mixed. It takes higher temperature to get mixed, while this is easily mixed. That means this sample is having less aromatic content, and that is what the importance is. Aniline point will give you the tendency of deterioration or aromatic hydrocarbons. So this will tell you how much aromatics are there. Obviously, if higher aniline point is there, then the lower percentage of aromatic is there, and that is desirable, because obviously aromatic contents are carcinogenic, they are corrosive, they are not good for health. So we would not want that our oil should have high aromatics. That's why whatever is the higher temperature, select that oil as a lubricant. to saponification number, it is number of milligrams of KOH which is required to saponify fatty acid present in 1 gram of oil. So it's basically a number, right? It does not have any unit. Let's say sample 1 is showing you 50, sample 2 is showing you around 10. This is the number. That means this is the amount of KOH required to saponify them. And that directly means that this sample is having less fatty acid. This sample is having more fatty acid. That's why more KOH is required. Now, what is the significance? First, it will tell you the amount of fatty acid. Yes, this sample is having more fatty acid. This sample is having less fatty acid. Also, you can differentiate the type of oil, because I guess you know that animal vegetable oil are glycerides of higher fatty acid. So they do have fatty acid, while mineral oil are hydrocarbons. They don't have fatty acid. So they don't saponify at all. That means petrol, diesel, kerosene, mineral oil, they don't saponify at all. And that's how you can differentiate. Now, adulteration. Like, let's say this is the oil, so I can say, but this could be a mineral oil, but this is giving you a value of 10. That means it's adulterated. It is mixed with some other oil, and because of which fatty acid value have come. So if the fatty acid value is high, that means it's animal vegetable oil. If it is low, it could be mineral oil. And then that's it. So I guess you're able to understand all the properties of lubricant. This was just a quick video to recap all the properties of lubricant. If you have liked the content, please hit like. That will give me motivation, and do share your comments. Thank you so much.